no question, let me give the evidence about this benefit of meditation that has taken place during our Lord Buddha's time. Here, the benefit of meditation I just now mentioned, out of the five, one benefit is, even if one missed the chance of attaining a Arya Bhukla or a noble person in this very life, if one die contemplating or meditating with mindfulness, one can surely be reborn in the realm of gods or celestial realm of devas, where one can continue one's practice and gain there. The evidence is by the name of Samana Deva. He is now still in Dvarasa realm. As you all know, there are six realms of celestial gods. The second celestial gods realm is Dvarasa, the realm of the 33 gods. Anyway, now he's still there. He was a bhikkhu or a young monk, about maybe 20 plus. And he took meditation instruction from our Lord Buddha. He go to a nearby forest, nearby village, and he practiced meditation, and he go to the extreme of not taking food. So as you all know, one single meal can sustain life only for 7 days. So at the end of 7 days, since he does not replenish his nutrition of food, he died while in meditation or meditating. And when he died, he was immediately reborn in this second realm of celestial gods, which you call Dvarasa. Here, by the way, and according to our Buddha's teaching and Abhidhamma, there are different types of jati or rebirth. One is, we call Samsidhaja. Samsidhaja is moisture born. Like macaws or certain creatures, they arise in these moisture or wet or excreta or any dirty places. They take life there. So these are Samsidhaja creatures. Then the second type of rebirth is Andhaja. Andhaja means eggborn. As you all know, birds, the poultry creatures like cocks, ducks, and even some turtles, they lay eggs. So the creatures are born. First, they had to be born as eggs. Then from there, they hatch into creatures. So such type of rebirth is called Andhaja rebirth. Andhaja means egg born. Egg, E-G-G, egg, egg born. And the fourth type of rebirth is Upapatika, like these celestial beings of devas and brahmas. When, like a human being dies, and if one is to be reborn in deva world or brahma world, they arise there instantaneously. That's Upapatika, means instantaneous, but they don't have to go through like conceiving as in the egg or in the mother's womb. They just arise there instantaneously after the death, immediately after death or instantaneously after death. And they arise in those realms at the prime of age. Like if a female deva will be about the age of 16 or 18, a male deva will be about 18 or 20, at the prime of age, and they appear there instantaneously at the time of death. So this Samana Deva, now he's still in Dvarasa. He died while meditating in the meditation retreat. And he was instantaneously born in this Dvarasa realm, or the second realm of gods. And when he found out himself that he was reborn in Dhavrayam Dharuram, he got so downhearted. But he aimed his Nibbana and he was reborn as a Deva. He thought that like a sportsman aiming for a gold medal has to be contented with a bundle of flowers or some leaves. So he came down to the Lord Buddha, he reported the matter and he did Buddha's instruction and he meditated and he became a noble person. So that is why the Pandu here mentioned as the benefit in the commentaries. Because the Deva realm, they are instantaneously, but like we humans, we had to stay in the mother's womb minimum 9 months, 9 to 10 months in the womb, of with all hardships there. And at the time of birth, that is a shock. And at the time of death, that is a shock. So we forgot up and we had to suffer greatly. Not like these devas, they are instantaneous rebirth without any hardship. So, and their food, as I mentioned the other day also, their nutrition is very fine material. They don't leave any undigested material like us. Our food is very gross and rough. After taking, we had to excrete like urine or sweat or feces. But these celestial beings, their nutriment is very subtle and fine. So they don't need any remnants. So that's why their intelligence is very high, IQ is very high. And when they meditate, they can easily gain this enlightenment, path and fruition. Chittas can arise easily. And the second comment I want to make is about the fifth benefit. One's meditation practice is never wasted. If you miss the four chances, you can still benefit. This meditation practice won't last. And we hear the commentary mentioned about Bahya Dharujariya. During the Buddha Kasapa, Gotabuddha Kasapa is immediately preceding our Lord Gautama Buddha. During that time, about seven monks, same thing, they climb on top of the mountain and practice their strenuous meditation there. And without food at the end of 7 days, this Bahya died. Not gaining any enlightenment, but only deeper practice. And he, with this meritorious deeds of insight meditation, he enjoyed only pleasurable rebirths in human and celestial realms for Bodhantara, meaning the two Buddhas' sadhana or teachings. And then our Lord Gautama Buddha's time, he was reborn in Sukvaraka Port, that is about southwest of India, Indian coast. There is a small port by the name of Sukvaraka. He was born there. And one day he went for trading with the Dulce, no steamers, driven, propelled by machine. They have only sailing boats, sailing ships. And in the middle of the ocean, the shipwreck. And he being the, we call in Bali, Pachimabhavika, he's the final existence. He before he gained any enlightenment, he won't die. But he was carried by the waves towards the shore, and he survived. One of his compatriots who meditated together with him was reborn as a Brahma and the Brahma realm. Brahmas, they have divine eye, Deva Chakku. So when he saw the plight of the Bahya, he came down and gave the information, Bahya, that is, Lord Gautama Buddha has already arisen and now he's residing at Savati. So, to arouse his emotional urgency or spiritual urgency. So he gets the spiritual urgency, and the whole night he ran towards from Soparaka to Savatthi, many, many kilometers or miles away. He went there by probably with the help of this celestial being. He reached the next morning to the Buddha, when Buddha was at that time on Armstrong, going for Armstrong and the town of Savatthi. And he reached there and he approached the Buddha. He most earnestly implored the Buddha to admonish Dhamma. First Buddha just to calm him down. But here I am on the Armstrong, and it is on the way and on the road. And Bahia requested the second time and the third time. Then when he's ready, Buddha give him. And that we often quote here because it is applicable to our meditation. Dete Dhamma Dhamma Vaisati. One. Two. Sute Sudhamma Dhamma Vaisati. Three. Mute Mudhamma Dhamma Vaisati. Vinyate Vinyatamma Dhamma Vaisati. He Buddha give just four stanza for us. By here, and seeing, just be seen. And hearing, just be hearing. And coming in contact, just be coming in contact. And knowing, just be knowing. And he followed Buddha's mean on that instant, on the roadside. And within the short time, he become arahant, a noble path, because of this path meditation experience during Lord Kaspa Buddha's time. Within that is that in Pali we call Khepa Bhenya Sukha Padipata, meaning Khepa Bhenya, quick attainment. Sukha Padipata, with comfortable practice. He did not go through long, strenuous practices now because of his past meritorious deed giving fruit. He understands what Buddha say in brief Dhamma. He can elaborately understand, and he follow with meditation, and he gain immediate enlightenment there. So that is the benefit we can get as a fifth chance.